Something big is about to happen, and you may not be able to save everyone, but there are one or two or three or maybe 10 people that you know, if you're a born-again believer, that are close. They may have a little bit of faith, or they may be curious about your faith, or maybe they've talked a little bit about God, and you know that they're trying to get your approval a little bit, knowing that you're a believer. But something is about to happen, and it's time that you reach out to those people that are close to you and try to help them see how important it is right now. I don't mean next week. I mean right now, that they acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord. I believe that the rapture of the church is imminent. I mean the church as in the body of Jesus Christ, the bride of Christ. I believe that it's imminent. There is a man that I follow on YouTube, and he, from years ago, had a message that he had a dream, and somebody in the dream had spoke to him. He said it wasn't an angel of the Lord or something, because he recognize the angel of the Lord, but somebody in this dream he had said that Billy Graham would pass away shortly before the rapture of the church. Well, this is the second week, I believe this is coming up on the second week of March 2018. Billy Graham has just passed away, and some of the so-called truthers, born-again truthers, are saying that we are in store for some very, very serious things. There are people that are saying that it's no coincidence that April Fool's Day is Good Friday or Easter, something like that. You need to check these things out for yourself and know that there may be something happen on April 3rd or April 18th. I don't know a lot about it, but apparently the 18th of April is the lunar 3rd in April. I don't follow these things very much, but I'm just trying to share some of the things with you, because you may not be listening to some of these same people. And again, these are just people. But Jesus himself said that you will know when it's harvest based on the signs of the season. He even cursed the fig tree because it wasn't bearing fruit, but it was giving off the signs of harvest. Let me read a couple things to you. This is Proverbs 4. Verse 20, my son, attend to my words, incline thine ear to my sayings. Let them not depart from thine eyes. That means you've got to read them yourself. Keep them in the midst of your heart. You know, you memorize things off by heart. Think about it. You can meditate or think on over and over the word of God. In fact, I'm going to share with you something that God spoke to me on the way home from the grocery store the other night. For they are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh. In North America, we don't often think about how critical life is to us, especially if you're, you know, younger. Maybe if you're sick, or maybe if you're an older person, then yeah, maybe you may think of life as a fragile thing. But most of us are just running off in life and trying to do our job and earn money and buy things and be involved in a lot of things that may or may not be very important. This is important. This is from Proverbs, the book of wisdom. Attend to my words. You say, my son, attend to my words. Incline thine ear unto my sayings. Whoa, you know what just dawned on me? This is wisdom speaking. My son, we are now, as Christians, joint heirs with Jesus, children of God. this is cool. My son is referring to me. It's referring to you. Tend to my words, incline thine ear unto my sayings, let them not depart from thine eyes, keep them in the midst of thy heart, for they are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh. Jesus said himself that there would be certain things that would identify his return. It's in Luke 21. I've been talking a lot about this lately. So go back and watch some more of my videos if you're curious about this. Okay? Luke 21, starting at verse 20. And when you shall see Jerusalem compassed with armies, then know that the desolation thereof is nigh. And skipping down to verse 25. And there shall be signs in the sun, and in the moon, and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring. I mean, upon the earth distress of nations with perplexity. Putin had his State of the Nation or State of the Union equivalent address, as it's supposed to be going up for election very soon. And he told all of his people, all of his leaders, all of his religious leaders as well, that Russia would respond with nuclear retaliation if there was any type of nuclear force exercised against Russia or their allies. And he said, regardless of the consequence. In my opinion, that is equivalent to him saying, if we cannot win, no one will win. This is talk that we haven't heard for almost, well, 40 years. Maybe almost 50 years from the Cold War. That Russia is declaring that they are the superpower, no longer just willing to be super partners, as they've been called before, that Russia and the U.S. super partners. No, they are still sore about not overwhelmingly winning World War II, and which ended up dividing Germany. And this is the underlying resentment that may trigger World War III, which may precede Armageddon. But this isn't doom and gloom. For the believer, we are expectantly waiting based on these signs. When you hear these things, Jesus said, verse 31, Luke 21, verse 31. So, likewise ye, when ye see these things come to pass, know ye that the kingdom of God is nigh at hand. This is good. You need to read Luke 21 for yourself. All right. Now back to this is what I really want to make video about now. Psalm 91. And this is what I sense God speaking to me on the way home from the grocery store. Driving down the road. Here it is. Psalm 91. Another good chapter to read. One of my favorite chapters. Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. To me, that says that it's not going to touch me. I may see it, but I have nothing to fear. Jesus is near. If you do not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can accept him and become a Christian right now. Simply pray this prayer with me. Say, Father God, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I am a sinner. I accept Jesus' sacrifice on the cross, his death, as punishment for my sins. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for me. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I accept Jesus as Lord of my life. Father God, help me to live for you, to live the way you want me to live. In Jesus' name, amen. I promise you that you will embark on the greatest adventure of your life. You may even encounter things that are so amazing that you will call them supernatural. That even though the world may be falling apart and in destroying itself through selfishness or through the corruption that's in the government or the media or in the financial systems or even in the religious systems, we have to simply stay close to Jesus, to stay close to God by reading His Word, by spending time in prayer, and not just some religious act that you stop and you formally bow your knees and fold your hands. And I'm not belittling that. I think that's precious. But if it's done to gain attention or if it's done to try to appease God, that's the wrong approach. You can talk to God anywhere, anytime. I think I'll leave it there for now and let you chew on that a little bit. You can share this with some people that maybe you're not real comfortable with sharing your faith. You can share this video in an email or however you communicate with your friends. You could share this video and just say, hey, check out what this guy's saying. And, you know, maybe even make it funny so that they are more apt to take a listen to this. But the time is short. People are only hearing part of the story. If you could take the truth of what's going on behind closed doors, which are heavily guarded secrets, and you could take the truth from the Word of God, and we read the King James Version, the authorized 1611 version, and try to pull as much out of it as God will allow our minds to comprehend. And I believe that He will reveal Himself to you. He will reveal Himself in a way that you can understand. And in step by step by step by step, as you prove yourself obedient, and as you prove yourself to be listening and paying attention and humbly taking His direction, He will give you more and more. My wife and I were talking about it today. It's the changes that we've made in the last year. We've stepped out on what we sense God saying or God warning us and God telling us, challenging us, and together have taken challenges head on and made some radical changes in our life as a result. And if you're really interested in some of that, you can listen through to some of my other videos. There's a playlist of just things God has done in my life, or type of like unreal, amazing things that of stories I tell from my life that God has done. And if you're listening to God and if you're sensing God leading or warning you about something, I mean, beware. You may not be able to shout it from the hilltops and warn hundreds and thousands of people, but there may be one or two or three people that you know specifically. I pray that God reveals them to your mind right now as I'm speaking this to you, that those people's names and their faces will pop up into your imagination right now as I'm talking, that the people that God has placed in your life for you to be a link in the chain to draw them closer to being connected with God. And this is something that is really important to me, that, you know, Jesus said in Matthew 28, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. And we each have a way to do that in the circle of influence that we're in. That you live as the living epistle or the living letter that most men will read. Most people, the only word that they will read is your testimony and your life, your lifestyle around them. So I don't mean to ramble on and on and on about it, but check it out. Psalm 91. Check out Proverbs 4. Check out Luke 21. And see for yourself, even Matthew 28. See for yourself some of these things from the Word of God that are warning us that it's not just some, you know, heavenly idea of, that you're so perfect that nobody can relate with you here on earth by being a Christian. No, not at all. It is that God has made you righteous through the sacrifice of His Son, and that you can relate with people. You can relate with anyone because we are in this together. We see things through a different perspective sometimes, but we're all exposed and vulnerable to the same things. Anyway, I pray God's hedge of protection around you now and declare that no weapon formed against you will prosper in the name of Jesus. And every tongue that rises in judgment against you, you shall show to be in the wrong. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. Be blessed. Thanks for watching.